Hi, let us learn how to create this beautiful animated scene of sun rising and lotus flowering. Take a look at this again. We have the lotus flowering beautifully in the morning while the sun rises. This tutorial shows you the different ways in which you can animate elements on your slide. So if anyone says you need to use complex programs like After Effects to create these kind of animations, you can always forward this video that is made entirely using PowerPoint. Let us recreate the scene from scratch. But before that, I am Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com, the creator of comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle, a collection of more than 4,500 premium animated PowerPoint templates that help you create beautiful and engaging presentations in minutes. The first thing I'm going to do is to create the petals of lotus. So let us go to Auto Shapes Gallery. From basic shapes, let us pick up this one called as the oval tool. Hold the shift button down and draw a circle. Then let me make a copy of this by pressing Ctrl D and place this right next to the previous one. Then let me select both of these and go to the option called intersect. Now we have the first petal created. I can always fill this with the color of my choice. Let us go to shape outline and give it a dark colored outline. Now I'm going to make a duplicate of this because I want a ghost shape that allows me to rotate this in the angle I want. So let me use Ctrl D, which is the shortcut for duplicate, and place this so that it touches the bottom corner of this petal. Let me right click, go to format shape and say fill, and let us have the transparency increased all the way till 100%, and let us have shape outline as no outline. While this ghost shape is selected, hold the shift button down and click on this petal and press Ctrl G to group. Now we have one petal created the right way. Now we need to create six more copies of this. So let us press Ctrl D to create our first one and let us place this somewhere over here and then press Ctrl D, Ctrl D. So we have three of them placed here. Let me press Ctrl D and move this to one side here. And just to differentiate the center one from the remaining ones, let me use a different color. I can always revert the color back. So this is the color that I've chosen for this. Now let us make two more copies to this side. Ctrl D and place it over here. And Ctrl D and place it over here. So those are the petals we have. The reason why I arranged like this is to just show you the kind of animations that we are going to apply to each of these petals. The first one is going to rotate to just 15 degrees. So let us select this, go to animations and go to add animation and say spin, and we are going to have this rotate only to 15 degrees. Let us go to animation pane, go here, go to effect options and say it needs to rotate 15 degrees clockwise, hit enter and say okay. So that is the extent to which it opens. Now we need to apply the same animation to the remaining two, only that the change in angle will be 30 degrees and 45 degrees here. So let me select this, use animation painter, double click it and use it for the next one and the next one. Now we need to make the changes here. So let me hit escape and then go to the second one and say effect options, and this one is 30 degrees as I mentioned earlier. Hit enter and say okay. And the next one is going to be 45 degrees. So let us go here and change this custom to 45 degrees. Hit enter and say okay. Now this is beautiful. Now we are going to apply the same animation to this side as well. So this is 15 degrees. Go to animation painter and the one that is closest is 15 degrees. The only change I'm going to do is to go here and say counterclockwise. So it goes to 15 degrees counterclockwise. Let us select this, animation painter, and go to the next one and let us change the angle to counterclockwise. Let us do the same thing for this one, animation painter, and copy it onto the next one and then change the effect options to counterclockwise. So we have got all kinds of beautiful angles applied, and all these are going to happen with previous. Beautiful. Now let me select all of these elements, then go to align top and then say align center. Now everything is one above the other. Now let us have all of these enter the scene. So let us go to add animation and say they all first need to float in. Since it's lotus, obviously it is floating in. And all this has to happen right at the beginning. And right after that, we are going to have this blossoming happening. So we say after previous. Now when I go to slideshow, this is how lotus would beautifully blossom out. Now you notice that it doesn't really look so attractive because the color is opaque. We need to add a bit of transparency so everything looks quite nice. So let me move this to one side and then select the transparency and increase it to say around 20% and hit enter. Now I could have done all this right at the start, but then I wanted to show you the problem that you would face if you don't have the transparency on the way that I showed you. So even before you create your first prototype, make sure that the transparency is added, and only then you apply animation and then you align so everything is one on top of the other. Now I did that. When I go to slideshow, you can see that the petals beautifully blossom out with transparency and it looks realistic. Now that we have our lotus bud in place, it is time to draw a couple of leaves. So let us go to Auto Shapes Gallery and pick up this one called as the curve tool. You will find that here in lines and it is over here called curve. You can always draw whatever shape you want. You can see that there is no real science to this. I'm just going to draw something very random. So this is the shape that I like, and go to shape fill and give it a green color. Go to shape outline and say no outline. You can adjust the size to suit your requirements, and I'm going to place it over here. And let me make a copy of this by pressing Ctrl D and then flip it horizontally and place it towards the side like this. Now we have got our leaves in place, and just to draw the stem, I'm going to use the same curve tool again, and let us have a curvy stem like this. Double click and we have got our stem, and let us have this in shape outline. Go to weight and increase it to around 6 points, and then change the color to this dark green. Now all of this looks quite nice. Now these elements also have to float in along with the bud. So let us select this and then go to float in animation for the same 1 second, and this happens with previous, and let us move these animation events along with the previous one. So we have the buds and the leaves and the stem all floating in at the same time. When I go to slideshow, everything floats in and then the blossoming happens. Now we have got our leaves, so we need to have these leaves floating on water. So let us go to home, go to rectangle tool and draw a rectangle in such a way that it represents water. Let me right click and send this to back, and let me reduce the width ever so slightly like this, and then I'm going to apply gradient fill. So let us go to shape fill, go to gradient and say this gradient, and let us go to shape outline and say no outline. And if you want to give this a little more realistic look, you can add a bit of transparency. Go to format shape, and to the bottom portion here, I can add a little bit of transparency like so, and to the center one, a bit more of transparency. So this mimics water. Excellent. Now we need to have sun rising so the blossoming happens. So let us go to Auto Shapes Gallery, pick up the oval tool, hold the shift button down and draw a large sun like this. You can go to shape fill and use this yellow color in the center, and we can always add gradient. So let us select this, go to gradient fill and then choose type as radial, and then we are going to have the direction to be from the center. The center one is going to be yellow, and somewhere towards the center we are going to have this orange color, and maybe to make it a little more dramatic, you can have this kind of an orange color maybe towards the rim, and go to shape outline and say no outline. Now this looks like a beautiful sun. Let us add some glow to this by going to effects option, glow, and go to presets and choose this glow here called glow 18 points, and then you can change the glow color to something like yellow. And of course you can always increase the size of this so it looks a little more interesting like this. Now this sun is going to be over here, and this flies in from below. So let us go to animations and say this needs to fly in, and this flies in, of course, not at this pace. It needs to happen fairly slowly, maybe around 3 seconds is a good one, and we need to have this behind. So I'm going to say send to back, and let us have this happen at the same time as the blossoming. So let us say happens with previous. Now when I go to slideshow, you can see how the scene works. We have the flowering happening first, and then we have the sun rising. That is not the way we want. So we need to adjust the duration a little bit and we need to move the animation events. So I'm going to move this animation event for this fly in for the sun to happen right along with the previous animation of all these elements. And I'm going to say that this happens after previous. And then we have this spin animation happen with a bit of delay. That is after it comes out of water. So we need to have the delay to be somewhere around 1 second. So that should be pretty much fine. And we need to have that for the other ones as well. I forgot to do that. So here we have 1 second delay. Now, when I show you how things work, we have on a click everything floating in happening simultaneously here. And after that, we have the sun rising. And then this blossoming happens. Let us go to slideshow and see if that is the way it works. On a click, we have the blossoming happening only after the sun rises like this. Now, this is pretty much what we want. Now, just there is one final thing we want to complete this effect, and that is we want this background to change its color. Let us go to home, go to this rectangle shape, and then draw a rectangle and have that serve as our background. I'm going to right click and send this to back. And I'm going to have this color to somewhere around this kind of gray color. So it represents the early morning darkness. Let us go to shape outline and say no outline. Now this is right at the back. As you remember, I have got it sent to back. And then while this sun rises, we have this change into light yellow color. So that is what we want to do. So let us select this and say animations, add animation. And this is going to change its object color, which is the option that is available under emphasis. And the color is going to be maybe this kind of orange color. Maybe, yeah, that is a good enough one. And this happens with previous. And this also happens with the same duration of, say, around 2 seconds. So everything looks beautiful. So when I go to slideshow, this is the dark morning and we have water. And on a click, we have the bud coming in. And then the sun comes up and you can see the sky changes its color and the blossom happens and everything is neat and tidy. Now, what you saw was an example of using animation creatively. Let me show you 3 examples of creative custom animation in PowerPoint that is used in our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle templates. The first example is this template where we show how you have multiple choices like this. And then on a click, we get to evaluate each one of these options. And then we select the right one like this. It's a concept that is applicable in a number of situations. You can use this slide as an analogy to represent the concept of selecting one from many options. The next example is that of an establishment breaking down. Now, this construction can be a metaphor for any establishment. On a click, we talk about 4 pillars of the establishment. Then on a click, we introduce stage 2 where the pillars are weakening. And then the final stage is when the entire establishment breaks down. This animation is done entirely inside PowerPoint and it helps you to communicate a very useful concept. The last example is a very common one which talks about driving a wedge. On a click, we talk about the wedge here. And then on a click, we talk about the action that drives a wedge and divides one thing into 2. Of course, you can always talk about what those 2 elements are after the animation. There are tons of such beautifully animated concepts in comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle. And that is what makes this bundle so different from the usual animated templates that you see on the net. So go ahead, click on the link in the description box below and see how comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle can change the way you create your presentations forever. In the meantime, do you want to learn some simple and creative PowerPoint ideas you can use in your next presentation? Then click on the link here to join our 5-day free email course called 25 Creative PowerPoint Ideas. These are simple, quick, and useful PowerPoint ideas I have not shared elsewhere. So go ahead, click on the link, join the course, and I will see you inside.